let me read the chat box. Whether the screen is visible to everyone? Okay. So as you can see on your screen, there is a statement, right? Democracy is a government of people, by the people and for the people. Do you know who said this statement? You might have read it for history classes, or it's a very statement which we have heard, right? So who said this statement? Yes, Sandesh. Who said this statement? Democracy is a government of the people, by the people and for the people. Okay, Shashank. Who said this? Ankit? Others, you may write down the answer in the chat box. Yes, Ankit. Bhumika? Meant.
Abraham Lincoln.
Right. So this statement is made by Abraham Lincoln. Do you know who is Abraham Lincoln? Tanvi, who is Abraham Lincoln? Yes, Tanvi. Who is Abraham Lincoln?
He was.
Yes.
Inventor of States of America.
Yes, he was the president of America, right? So today we are going to read poem written by Abraham Lincoln. Okay. So before moving forward, let us quickly read a brief biography about the poet Abraham Lincoln. Okay, so Abraham Lincoln, as all of you said, he was the president of he was born February 1808 United States, and was the 16th president of the United America, right? So what he has done? He was an opponent of the system of slavery. He opposed of slavery and introduced the measure slavery in the states. Okay, and later on 1865, he was assassinated. So he was assassinated, was murdered because of political reason.
Mataji.
Yes.
Mataji, voice is breaking.
Okay. Okay. Now, am I audible?
Yes, Mataji.
Okay. So there was a little bit disturbance. That's why it happened. Sorry for that. Okay. Let me continue now. Abraham Lincoln. He was assassinated on 15th April 1865. The word assassinate means murdered because of some political or religion cause. Okay, so he was murdered stand. And on 15th April 1865, he was assassinated. Okay, now let us read the poem written by Abraham Lincoln. The title of the poem is very apt, right? Abraham Lincoln's letter to his son's teacher. This is the poem. The letter is written in the form of a poem. Okay, and in this letter, he's giving some suggestions to his child's instructor or the teacher. What is he telling in his the letter? In the letter, he is describing the qualities in which the teacher has to train his child, like values or the qualities or the attitudes towards life. He, in his letter, he mentions both positive and negative aspects of the life or the world. So usually every parents who sends their children to school, they expect the best education, right? And they want their children to grow up and become a successful person. But everyone's perception of success is different, right? Somebody wants their son to achieve 100% marks. Some of them wants to become their children successful in all the aspects of life, not only marks, but also in each and every sphere of life. So in this poem, Abraham Lincoln is suggesting his child's teacher the field or the sphere of life wherein his child has to gain knowledge, not only in academic, but also the life lessons. A very beautiful letter it is. And it is very important for both a teacher as well as a student to go through this letter and understand what is he really trying to convey. What is education according to Abraham Lincoln? Shall we read the poem? Okay. Abraham Lincoln's letter to his son's teacher. Let me read the first two stanza once. Please go through the lines as I read it on. Okay. He will have to learn. I know that all are not just and all men are not true. But teach him also that for every scoundrel there is a hero. And that for every selfish politician, there is a dedicated leader. Teach him, for every enemy, there is a friend. It will take time, I know. But teach him, if you can, that a dollar earned is of far more value than 5 pounds. So we have read the first two stanza of the poem. Let us analyze these two stanzas now. Abraham Lincoln's letter to his son's teacher. Look at the first three lines. He will have to learn. See the line. He will have to learn. He doesn't have any choice. He has to learn. What he has to learn? That all men are not just. That just means fair or honest. Not all men are fair or honest, and not all men are true. There is also a negative side of a person. He will have to learn. Who is he here? Yes, he refers to Abraham Lincoln's son. I know means he is referring himself. And he says that not all men are true, not all men are fair or honest. He has to know it. But teach him also that for every scoundrel, there is a hero. And also teach him what teacher has to teach him. For every scoundrel, there is a hero. Here, scoundrel means a dishonest person or a bad person. If there is a bad person, and then there is a good person as well, right? For every bad person in this world, there is a good person. Teach him that also. That for every selfish politician, there is a dedicated leader. So you may found or you may see around you a selfish politician who doesn't work for the citizens, but there is also a dedicated leader who serves the country selflessly, right? So we have a scoundrel as well as a hero. We have a selfish politician as well as a dedicated leader. Yes? So we find both type of people around us. Teach him, for every enemy, there is a friend. If there is an enemy, then there is definitely a friend is there for us. Teach him that too. Look at all these lines, right? In all these lines, he is asking his child's teacher to teach him both positivity as well as negative aspect of the life. His child should know that goodness exists also. There is a negativity in the world. By saying all these lines, he is trying to convey the message that one should have faith in people. If there is bad person, then there is also a good person. That's why have faith in goodness. Whereas evil things also there in the world. But one should not lose faith in positivity, in goodness. That's why open your eyes and see both goodness as well as evil things in the world. It will take time, I know, but teach him if you can that a dollar earned is of far more value than 5 pounds. It will take time. So all these teachings or understanding all these concepts takes time. I know. He's saying he knows. These all lessons cannot be taught in a day or two. It takes time. Yes, and teach him if you can. See how he is addressing his child's teacher. If you can, right? That a dollar earned is of far more value than 5 pounds. That means hard earned money or the money which comes out of a hard work is far valued than easily got money. That means one should work hard and earn money rather than expecting a quick money from someone. That's why don't be greedy for quick money. Instead, work hard and earn. It is more honorable than getting an easy money. So a dollar earned is far honorable, respectable than getting a quick 5 pounds. Teach him to learn to lose and also to enjoy winning. Steer him away from envy if you can. Teach him the secret of quiet laughter. Let him learn early that the bullies are the easiest to lick. Now he is talking about the life situations, right? Losing and winning. Teach him to learn to lose. So there is a famous quote, right? We all always use it. That is, failure is the stepping stone for success. Which means that one should also know how to lose. Yes, if you don't know how to lose or if you haven't gone through that feeling, then you cannot enjoy the feel of winning. So experiencing both losing as well as winning is most important in our life. If you don't know how it feels to lose, then you cannot enjoy the win to the fullest. That's why teach him to learn to lose and also to enjoy winning, and let him enjoy his win to the fullest, and also how to accept the lose, teach him that as well. Steer him away from envy if you can. Teach him the secret of quiet laughter. Steer. Here the word steer means guide. Guide him. Guide my child to stay away from envy. You have come across this word. Envy means jealousy. Guide him to stay away from jealousy if you can. Teach him the secret of quiet laughter. Here, the secret of quiet laughter means teach him to be happy with himself. Sometimes we do this kind of unnecessary activity, right? So we expect others to make us happy. But one should know that happiness is a state of mind, right? If you choose to be happy, then definitely you will be happy. So teach him, teach my child the secret of quiet laughter. Teach him to be happy always. There is no reason for being happy, right? You can be happy anytime. It's just a state of mind. Teach him that, the secret of quiet laughter. Let him learn early that the bullies are the easiest to lick. Teach him in the early itself what a teacher must teach his child in the early stage itself, that the bullies are the easiest to lick. Bullies. You might have heard this word, bully. Bully means a person who uses their strength to frighten other people or hurt the weaker people. Yes, in usually academic environment, we hear this kind of word, bullying, right? So these bullies, they pretend as if they are strong, but in reality, they are easiest to lick. Lick means to defeat easily. You can defeat the bullies very easily. Teach my child that the bullies are easiest to defeat. And the teacher must teach him in the early stage itself that the bullies are easiest to defeat. Teach him, if you can, the wonder of books, but also give him quiet time to ponder the eternal mystery of birds in the sky, bees in the sun, and the flowers on the green hillside. Abraham Lincoln asking his child's teacher to teach him the wonder of books. Teach his child to love the books, to read the books, to enjoy the books. So when we read books, we find so many imaginary, fantasy, as well as real aspects of life, right? We come across so many wonders, magics. So teach him to wonder of books. Teach him to read the books and experience the life. And also give him quiet time. Give him some space. Space for what? Time for what? To ponder. Here the word ponder means to think over a matter very carefully. To think the eternal mystery of birds in the sky. Yes, so he is asking his child's teacher not to make him a bookworm. One should love to read, but should not be a bookworm, right? Should also explore his surroundings. See the sky, see the environment, see the trees, birds, everything which is surrounded around him. Look at the mystery of the birds in the sky. Take some time and ponder on these all aspects of nature. See the bees in the sun and the flowers on the green hillside. Don't only read books, but also look at your surrounding. Try to solve the mystery behind those natural aspects. In the school, teach him it is far honorable to fail than to cheat. Teach him to have faith in his own ideas, even if everyone tells him they are wrong. Teach him to be gentle with gentle people and tough with. So in the school, he is asking the teacher to teach him it is far honorable to fail than to cheat, right? I hope all of you agree with this point. It is far honorable to fail than to cheat. If you work hard, read everything, even then, if you get less mark or fail, it doesn't matter because you have tried hard. That is more honorable than cheating in the exam and winning the or being first at the class. That is less honorable, right? I hope all of you agree with me. Work hard, then if you get less marks, that is far honorable than cheating and winning the exam or winning the race, right? That's why teach him to have faith in his own ideas, even if everyone tells him they are wrong, right? So this is what even every teacher asks you to do, right? Have faith in your own ideas. Though others are not agree with you or they are opposing you, the whole class may be going in one direction, and if you are very firm about your ideas and if you know that your ideas are true, then have faith in your ideas. Though everyone tells you that you are wrong. So one should have belief in themselves, in their ideas, in their decisions. One should take advice from others, but one should also have faith in their ideas, in their thoughts, in their opinion. Teach him to be gentle with gentle people and tough with the tough. So, also teach my child, Abraham Lincoln is telling the teacher that teach my child to be gentle with gentle people. Yes, if there is an old person or a very small kid or a person who has some disadvantage, underprivileged people, be gentle with them. Yes. And if there is a tough person who is having a bad persona, then be the same with him. How a person treats you, you must treat him the same, right? Gentle with gentle, tough with tough. Teach him that as well. Okay, students, I'll stop the discussion here itself. Let us read the poem once again. Okay. Chinmay Chaudhary, unmute yourself and please read the poem once. Chinmay Chaudhary. Okay, Yashaswini. Yashaswini.
Yes, Mataji.
If you have the book with you or the screen is visible, will you please read the poem once till we have discussed?
Okay. Okay, Mataji. He will have to learn, I know, that all men are not just, all men are not true, but teach him also that for every scoundrel there is a hero, that for every selfish politician there is a dedicated leader. Teach him for every enemy there is a friend. It will take time, I know. But teach him, if you can, that a dollar earned is of far more value than five found. Teach him to learn to lose and also to enjoy winning. Steer him away from envy, if you can. teach him the secret of quiet laughter. Let him learn early that the bullies are the easiest to lick. Teach him, if you can, the wonder of books, but also give him quiet time to ponder the eternal mystery of birds in the sky, bees in the sun, and the flowers on a green hillside. In this school, teach him it is far honorable to fail than to cheat.
Just four lines.
Teach him to have faith in his own ideas, even if everyone tells him they are wrong. Teach him to be gentle with gentle people and tough with the tough.
Okay. Thank you, Ashaswini. Okay, students, I will briefly tell the summary of this five stanzas in Kannada. If you haven't understood, just listen to me carefully, okay? ಈ ಪತ್ರ ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಒಂದು ಪದ್ಯ ಅಬ್ರಹಾಂ ಲಿಂಕನ್ ಅವರು ಬರೆದಿದ್ದು, ಈ ಪದ್ಯ ಒಂದು ಲೆಟರ್ ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅದೊಂದು ಪದ್ಯದ ಮಾದರಿಯಲ್ಲಿದೆ. ಈ ಪದ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಬ್ರಹಾಂ ಲಿಂಕನ್ ಅವರು ಅವರ ಮಗನ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಗುರುಗಳಿಗೆ ಬರೆದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಪತ್ರ ಇದು. ಈ ಪತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯ ಗುಣಗಳನ್ನು ತನ್ನ ಮಗನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬೆಳೆಸಿ ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ಗುಣಗಳನ್ನು ಅಥವಾ ಮೌಲ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು ಹೇಳುವಂತಹ ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ಅವರಿಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್, ಅವನು ಇದನ್ನು ಕಲಿಯಲೇಬೇಕು. ಏನನ್ನು ಕಲಿಬೇಕು? ಎಲ್ಲ ಮನುಷ್ಯರು ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕನಲ್ಲ, ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರೂ ಸತ್ಯವನ್ನೇ ಹೇಳೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಸುಳ್ಳು ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ಬರು ಅಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕರಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಅವರು ಕಲಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದೇನು? ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಮನುಷ್ಯರು ಇರ್ತಾರೋ, ಪ್ರತಿ ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಿಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಕೂಡ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ, ಸ್ಕೌಂಡ್ರಲ್, ಹಾಗೆ ಹೀರೋ. ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಿರುವ ಹಾಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಕೂಡ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ. ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಸೆಲ್ಫಿಶ್ ಪೊಲಿಟೀಷಿಯನ್, ಹೇಗೆ ಕೇವಲ ತನ್ನ ಸ್ವಂತ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ವಂತಿಕೆಗಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ರಾಜಕಾರಣಿಯನ್ನ ನೋಡ್ತೇವೋ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕನಾದಂತಹ ನಾಯಕನೂ ಕೂಡ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನ ಹೇಳಿ ಅವರು ಹೇಳುವುದೇನೆಂದ್ರೆ, ಜಗತ್ತನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಹಾಗೆ ನೆಗೆಟಿವಿಟಿ ಕೂಡ ಹಾಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದು ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಕೂಡ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ನಂಬಿಕೆಯನ್ನ ಕಳೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳಬಾರ್ದು. ಕೆಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಇದೆ ಅಂತಾದ್ರೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದು ಕೂಡ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರುವ ಕಾರಣ ನಾವು ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರ ಮೇಲೆ ನಂಬಿಕೆಯನ್ನ ಇಡಬೇಕು. ಸರಿ, ಹಾಗೆ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ನಮಗೆ ಎನಿಮಿಗಳಿರುತ್ತಾರೋ, ಶತ್ರುಗಳಿರುತ್ತಾರೋ, ಹಾಗೆ ಮಿತ್ರರು ಕೂಡ ಇರುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಎನಿಮಿ, ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಇದು ಎರಡು ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ವಿರುದ್ಧ, ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿರುದ್ಧವಾದಂತಹ ವಿಷಯಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನ ಕಲಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ದಿನದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಮಯ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಐ ನೋ, ಎಸ್. ಆದ್ರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾದರೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್, ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾದರೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಏನಂತ, ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟು ಗಳಿಸಿದ $1 ಬಹಳ ಸುಲಭವಾಗಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಂತಹ £5 ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಗೌರವಯುತವಾದದ್ದು. ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟು ದುಡಿದಂತಹ ದುಡ್ಡು ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠವಾದದ್ದು. ಬಹಳ ಸುಲಭವಾಗಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಂತ ಹಣ ಎಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡಿದರೂ ಅದು ನಮಗೆ ದಕ್ಕೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ತನ್ನ ಮಗನ ಹೇಳೋ ಪ್ರಕಾರ, ತನ್ನ ಮಗನಿಗೆ ಹೇಗೆ ನೀವು ಗುರಿಯನ್ನ ಸಾಧಿಸುವುದನ್ನ ಅಥವಾ ಗೆಲ್ಲುವುದನ್ನ ಕಲಿಸ್ತೀರೋ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಸೋಲನ್ನ ಒಪ್ಪಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವುದನ್ನ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಸೋಲು ಮತ್ತೆ ಗೆಲುವು ಎರಡು ಬಹಳ ಬೇಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇವೆರಡನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಸಮಾನವಾಗಿ ಒಪ್ಪಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವುದನ್ನ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಅಸೂಯೆಯ ಪಡುವಂತಹ ಭಾವನೆಗಳಿಂದ ಅವನನ್ನ ದೂರ ಇಡಿಸಿ. ಸ್ಟೇ ಅವೇ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎನಿಮಿ. ಅಸೂಯೆಯ ಪಡುವ ಗುಣವನ್ನ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಬೇಡಿ. ಹೇಗೆ ಅಸೂಯೆಯನ್ನ ಪಡಬಾರದು ಆ ರೀತಿಯ ಗುಣವನ್ನ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಟೀಚ್ ಹಿಮ್ ದ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಯಟ್ ಲಾಫ್ಟರ್. ಖುಷಿಯಾಗಿರುವುದನ್ನು ಅಥವಾ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಧನಾತ್ಮಕವಾಗಿ ವರ್ತಿಸುವುದನ್ನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಖುಷಿ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ದುಃಖ ಇವೆಲ್ಲದೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರಲ್ವಾ, ಅದು ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಕಾರಣದ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಧನಾತ್ಮಕವಾಗಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಗುಣಗಳನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಮೊದಲೇ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸಿ, ಅದೇನೆಂದರೆ ಬುಲೀಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಬೇರೆಯವರಿಗೆ ಹಿಂಸಿಸ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಅವರನ್ನು ಸೋಲಿಸುವುದು ಬಹಳ ಸುಲಭ. ಅವರು ತಮ್ಮನ್ನು ತಾವು ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಸಮರ್ಥರು ಅಂತ ತಿಳಿದುಕೊಂಡರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವರನ್ನು ಸೋಲಿಸುವುದು ಅಥವಾ ಅವರಿಂದ ದೂರವಿರುವುದು ಬಹಳ ಸುಲಭ. ಈ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲು ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಸ್ಟೀರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನವನ್ನು ನೀಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸ್ಟೀರ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನವನ್ನು ನೀಡಿ, ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಸರಿ, ಟೀಚ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್, ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾದರೆ ಈ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಏನು? ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಗೆ ತಿಳಿದುಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು, ಪುಸ್ತಕದ ಬಗ್ಗಿನ ಒಲವನ್ನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಪುಸ್ತಕಗಳನ್ನು ಓದಿ ಹೊಸ ಹೊಸ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನು ತಿಳಿದುಕೊಳ್ಳುವುದನ್ನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಆದರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಮಯವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನೀಡಿ. ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ? ತನ್ನ ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತಲಿನ ಪರಿಸರವನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನು ಕಲಿತುಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಮಯವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನೀಡಿ. ಪಾಂಡರ್ ದ ಎಟರ್ನಲ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೈ. ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳನ್ನು, ಮರಗಿಡಗಳನ್ನು, ನಮ್ಮ ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತಲಿನ ಪರಿಸರದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೀತಿಯ ವಸ್ತುಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಅದರ ಕುರಿತಾದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಕುತೂಹಲವನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಸಮಯವನ್ನು ಕೇವಲ ಪುಸ್ತಕದ ಹುಳುವನ್ನಾಗಿಸಬೇಡಿ. ಸರಿ, ಹಾಗೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ತರಗತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದು ಏನಂದ್ರೆ, ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟು ಓದಿ ಅವನು ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗದೇ ಇದ್ದರೂ ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಲ್ವ, ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಟು ಚೀಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್. ಅವನಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ಚೀಟಿಂಗನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿ ಗೆಲ್ಲುವಂತಹ ಗುಣವನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸಬೇಡಿ. ಅವನಿಗೆ ಸೋಲಾದರೂ ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಆದರೆ ಚೀಟ್ ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ನಕಾರಾತ್ಮಕ ಗುಣಗಳನ್ನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಬೇಡಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ತನ್ನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್, ತನ್ನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಐಡಿಯಾಗಳ ಮೇಲೆ ನಂಬಿಕೆ ಇಡುವಂತಹ ಗುಣವನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವನ ನಂಬಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಅಥವಾ ಅವನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ವಿರೋಧಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ನಂಬಿಕೆ ಇದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದು ಸರಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತಾದರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ತನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ತಾನು ನಂಬಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟು ಮುಂದುವರಿಯುವ ಗುಣವನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಅವರು ಕಲಿಸಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಏನಂತ? ಬಿ ಜೆಂಟಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟಫ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಟಫ್. ಬಹಳ ಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಅಥವಾ ಈಗ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತಲೂ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ ವಯಸ್ಸಾದವರ ಜೊತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಜೊತೆ ನಾವು ಇವರನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಜೆಂಟಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೇವೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವರ ಮನಸ್ಸು ಅಥವಾ ಅವರ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿತ್ವ ಹಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅವರ ಜೊತೆ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ವ್ಯವಹರಿಸಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಬಹಳ ಟಫ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾನವೀಯ ಗುಣಗಳ ವಿರುದ್ಧ ಅವನು ವರ್ತಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅವನೊಂದಿಗೆ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ವರ್ತಿಸು ಅಥವಾ ಅವನನ್ನ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಪಾಠವನ್ನ ಕಲಿಸು ಹೇಳುವಂತಹ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಅಬ್ರಹಾಂ ಲಿಂಕನ್ ಅವರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನ ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತನ್ನ ಮಗನಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ. ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಪಾಲಕರು ಬಯಸುವುದು ಅಥವಾ ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಬಯಸುವುದು ಏನಂದ್ರೆ, ತಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಪಾಠವನ್ನ ಓದಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಅಂಕಗಳನ್ನ ಪಡಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಬಯಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಆದರೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಪತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಬ್ರಹಾಂ ಲಿಂಕನ್ ಅವರು ತನ್ನ ಮಗನಿಗೆ ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಅಥವಾ ಮನುಷ್ಯನ ಬದುಕಿನ ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ಗುಣಗಳನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಈ ಒಂದು ಪತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ತನ್ನ ಮಗನ ಗುರುಗಳಿಗೆ ಬರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೈವ್ ಸ್ಟಾನ್ಸಾಸ್ are comprehensible to everyone. All of you have understood the poem. So let me just quickly discuss some part of the poem. Question. Vidya, the first question. In the first line, he refers to. Vidya. Okay, Aryan. Give me the answer for the first question, Aryan. Ambika. Ambika. Aditya. Okay, Shravya. Shravya. I hope all of you are in the class itself.
Yes, Mataji.
Can you give the answer for the first question?
Mataji, in the first line, he refers to Abraham Lincoln's son.
And I refers to?
Abraham Lincoln.
Correct. So here, first one, he refers to Abraham Lincoln's son and I refers to Abraham Lincoln. Right. Anant, second one. The first line, he will have to learn means that? Anant?
Yes, Mataji.
Second one.
The son has no choice.
Yes, because he has to learn it, right? So he has no choice. Correct. Next, Vaishnavi. All men are not just convey.
Madhaji, can you repeat the question?
Okay. See, all men are not true. And all men are not just. These lines suggests that
the harsh reality of life.
Correct. So it is a harsh reality, right? We always think that everyone are true, but it is not the case. So it is the harsh reality of life. Correct. Next, Shravani. Fourth one, the statement, for every scoundrel there is a hero, means? Shravani. Okay, Kritika. Swati.
Yes, Mataji.
Fourth question.
For every bad in this world, there is a good person.
Right. So for every bad person, there is a good person in the world. That's why he said, for every scoundrel, there is a hero. Right? Okay. Next one. Sushrita. The first seven lines emphasize. Sushrita.
Yes, Mataji.
Sixth question.
Mataji, both the positive and the negative side of the life.
Correct. So he repeated that there is also a positive side as well as a negative side of life. Correct. So the last one, if you have the book with you, pick out the line which says that hard earned money has greater value than easy money. Pranav Hegde?
Yes, Mata ji.
Can you pick out dollar, or identify the line?
That a dollar earned is of far more value than five earned.
Correct. So it says that a hard earned money is always greater or honorable, better than easy money. Correct? Yes. So I hope with this, all of you have understood the poem, not the whole poem, but the part which we have discussed today. Yes, if you have any queries or doubts or confusion, you may unmute the mic and speak up, or you may also write it in the chat box. Is there any confusion? Purnachandra Hegde?
Yes, Mataji.
Is there any doubt?
No, Mataji.
Okay. So I hope the poem is comprehensible to everyone. We will discuss the rest of the poem in our next period. Until then, I want you to read the stanzas which we have discussed today. Yes? And let me know if you have any confusion or doubts. Okay? Now, you may leave the class.